Now that we know how we're able to store information, it's time to turn to the next crucial part in the study of memory, and that's our ability to retrieve the information that we've stored. So retrieval is our ability to recall information that's previously been stored in our memories. Remember, we talked about two different types of memory, explicit and implicit. And with implicit memory, we can recall something without consciously trying to do so. I like to tell my students an example of me trying to learn how to knit. I looked at books and tried to follow their examples to no avail. So I ended up taking a lesson. And I had a teacher who showed me how to hold the knitting needles, how to hold the yarn, and more importantly, how to wrap it around such that I could make a knitted stitch. So I practiced and practiced my knitting, and I made several scarves. And then summer came and I put my knitting away. Now, as Christmas got closer, I thought it'd be really nice if I could knit each of my nieces a scarf. And then I realized I'd forgotten all the rules that my teacher taught me. But I did remember what I know about memory. And so I thought just maybe if I pick up those knitting needles, my hands will remember what to do. And that's exactly what happened. I picked up my needles and I started knitting. So this is a good example of implicit memory and, more importantly, procedural memory.